So today we're going to talk a little bit about arrays and strings in C. So these are concepts that you're familiar with from Java. So let's talk about some of the ramifications with C's model of dealing with these things at a slightly lower level and having to manage the actual memory. So in C, array names are really just essentially aliases that are used as pointers. And so these two lines are roughly equivalent. They both create an array of four integers and initialize those integers to 2, 3, 4, and 5. Those are laid out in consecutive locations in memory. And then there is an alias or a pointer called Y. And for now, there's some caveats that we'll talk about later, but for now, it's good for you to be thinking about this as being a separate integer that's stored as a separate variable, and its name is Y. And it is a pointer to the array. And specifically, it's a pointer to the first element of the array. It's important to recognize that you can access all of the other elements as well, as long as you have the pointer to the first element and you know how big each element is. And so in some sense, indexing and dereferencing are really the same operation, and there is an equivalency in C. Accessing the first element of an array is equivalent to just dereferencing the array pointer here. So Y is a pointer that points to this array. The array itself doesn't really have a name in this particular example. It's just a region of memory that has enough space for four integers consecutively laid out in memory. And so dereferencing that pointer gets you the first element in the same way that indexing at index 0 would also get you the first element. Similarly, if we want to get the second element, we could use the indexing notation and access index 1, or we can take the pointer and we can add one element to it by saying y plus 1, and this is actually called pointer arithmetic, and then we can dereference that pointer. And so when we add 1 to y, we get a pointer to the next element in memory, and then we can dereference that. And it's important to note here that the compiler needs to know how big each of these elements are in order to be able to calculate the address of the second element that might be different depending on the size of each element in the array. So for instance, if we had, as we might assume, a standard sized integer 4 bytes, then the second element is going to be at offset 4 from the initial address. And then the second element will be at offset 8 and so forth. And so you're essentially multiplying by the size of the element every time. Now, if on the other hand, we had an array of 8-bit integers or 1-byte integers, then we would be multiplying by 1 in order to convert the index into an offset, because if every element is only 1 byte long, then you can simply add the index to the base and you'll get the address of the element that you're looking for. And so that's why it's really, really important to know the types of your array pointers in C. The type is used to determine the size of the element, which is used during the offset calculations.